What is a flexor pronator strain of the elbow, and what do you do to recover from it? I'm Dr. David, orthopedic surgeon, sports medicine specialist, and author of That's Gotta Hurt, The Injuries That Change Sports Forever. I provide education, information, and commentary on all sorts of sports and exercise, injuries, injury treatments, and injury prevention for athletes and active people so that you can stay healthy and perform your best. Flexor pronator injuries are probably not the most common elbow injuries people suffer compared to things like golfer's elbow and tennis elbow and maybe distal biceps tendon ruptures, but they can be a real problem, especially for a baseball pitcher. The flexor and pronator muscles are these muscles off the inside of the elbow, on the side, like if you turn your palm up, these are the muscles on the side of the little finger. They attach to that bony prominence there, what's called the medial epicondyle, but people think of it as the funny bone. And what those muscles do is they flex the wrist and they pronate the forearm, or turn the forearm so that the palm is down. Very involved in the pitching motion to help stabilize the inside of the elbow. And you can basically injure this with either a traumatic injury, one single throw that basically strains that muscle group, usually right off that bony prominence, that medial epicondyle, just past that. You can even tear it that way, or it can be sort of a repetitive overuse injury. And it's honestly one that is very aggravating. It's sort of, when you hear people talk about it, you know, pitchers that are suffering this, they complain of sort of a dull, achy pain with it, but it can be one that really limits your ability to pitch or do whatever the other activities are. Now, we can make the diagnosis by physical exam, you know, weakness with wrist flexion, weakness with pronation, or pain at that location when you try to do those motions. And we can also get an MRI to look at, you know, basically that muscle tendon origin, see if there's fluid in that area, see if there's a partial or, yeah, even rarely a complete tear. Fortunately, in my experience, I rarely get people that have complete tears. A lot of times it's just sort of a strain of that muscle origin. So very rarely, in my experience, does that need surgery. It's not to say it couldn't happen, especially at maybe the Major League Baseball level, but sometimes that, you know, is needed, honestly. Surgery can be needed. But again, most of the time, physical therapy, rest from throwing, is enough to get better. It may take sometimes, you know, a couple weeks, it may take 4 to 6 weeks, but usually that's enough to get it better. One thing that's always interesting though is you also have to keep in mind, is there a possibility that something else is going on? Sometimes it may seem like a flexor pronator injury, but then, you know, somebody's just not getting better, not getting back to pitch without just pain on the inside of the elbow. Maybe there's an underlying ulnar collateral ligament injury or UCL injury that potentially might need Tommy John surgery. If you remember years ago when Steven Strasburg ended up suffering that UCL injury, in the week or so before they made the diagnosis of UCL injury and he underwent Tommy John surgery, the diagnosis was flexor pronator strain and wasn't getting better, got the test that would basically go on to reveal that he needed Tommy John surgery. So something to think about if somebody's just not getting better. But fortunately, if you truly have a flexor pronator strain, a strain of those flexor pronator muscles, usually it can get better without surgery. All right, have you suffered a flexor pronator strain, or maybe one of your family members has? How did you do it? How did, you know, your pain develop? What kinds of treatments did your doctor recommend, and how did you get better? Did physical therapy work? Did you end up needing surgery? I'd love to hear your experience, and honestly, I think viewers all around the world would love to hear it as well, so they can learn from you. Below this video, leave your comments and share your experience so we can hear how you got over a flexor pronator strain. If you like videos like this and you want more information on sports and exercise, injuries, injury treatments, and injury prevention, subscribe to my video channel. Click the subscribe button in the upper right corner of the page. I record a few of these videos every single week and they'll get delivered directly to you. Thank you so much for watching. If you know somebody dealing with the flexor pronator strain, please share this video with them so hopefully they can get better. And I look forward to seeing you right here next time.